It's April and this is the Library Roadshow. On the show today, authors, construction, and sweeping panoramic views. Welcome to the April edition of the Library Roadshow. I'm Mary Stein, and this is a production of your East Baton Rouge Parish Library System. Our spring One Book, One Community series is in full swing with in-person programs throughout the system and virtual programs on YouTube, Facebook, and other digital channels. I'm delighted that Dr. Robin Merrick will be leading one of the discussion groups, and we're also offering programs that tie in with the book, such as programs on oral history, genealogy, Katrina, and even home buying. It's all leading up to a visit from National Book Award winner Sarah Broom, the author of our featured book, The Yellow House. She'll be joined by best-selling author Margaret Wilkerson Sexton for a special program right here in May. I'm also pleased to announce that we're resuming Saturday Science, and we're starting off with a bang. NASA Deputy Chief Engineer for the Mars 2020 mission, Keith Como, will join us virtually on Saturday, April 17th, for a presentation on our newest favorite robot, the Perseverance Mars Rover. We'll be making some noise with free outdoor performances by the Baton Rouge Concert Band and the Civic Orchestra of Baton Rouge. Author Marianne Sternberg will share stories taken from along the River Road, while the Garden Discovery series focuses on the Baton Roots Community Farm. On a more serious note, a new Let's Talk series focuses on opioid misuse and prevention, and of course, helpful workshops from the Career Center, organization, computer help, and more are scheduled for April. Find out more in the source or in the online calendar of events.
Free access to books, audio, and library resources are just a few of the benefits available to you when you get a library card. Need free access to a computer? You get that. Want free access to premium digital resources like Mango Languages and Lynda.com? You get that. Need to book a meeting space? You get that. Heck, you can even check out a telescope or use a digital printer with your library card. If you live in East Baton Rouge Parish, pick up your free library card from your local branch library today. Premium access to everything the library system has to offer is waiting for you.
We've seen an uptick in usage of newspapers and magazines as folks are making a conscious effort to balance what might be coming in through their social media feeds with content from other, perhaps more reliable sources. One such comprehensive news source is PressReader in the digital library.
PressReader in the EBRPL digital library offers nearly 7,000 newspapers and magazines from around the world, online and always available. You'll find newspaper titles from the Chicago Tribune to the Times of India, and magazine titles from Newsweek, Golf Digest, and Women's Health to my personal favorite, Modern Cat. It's user-friendly, simple to navigate, and all titles appear as they would in print, including advertisements and classifieds. You can search for a specific title or browse by subject, country of publication, or language. A nice feature is that you can print pages, which is especially useful for all the cooking and food magazines. It offers accessibility options, like increasing the font size and options to listen to articles. There are so many titles in PressReader, there is sure to be something of interest you'll want to look at. To check out PressReader, head over to the digital library page at ebrpl.com.
Thanks, Andrew. I really like the fact that you can get a sense of specific country or region. Perfect for all of our global entrepreneurs. And of course, this news platform is a great complement to our NewsBank database, which includes The Advocate, as well as other regional and national papers. Our EBSCO platform features thousands of journals and magazines, and we also offer several databases that capture industry news. News junkies will never run out of things to read. Let's shift gears and check in with Kayla Perkins reporting in from Beyond the Stacks.
We're at the main library at Goodwood to celebrate the One Book, One Community selection, The Yellow House by Sarah M. Broom. We're going to find out the connection between working with textiles and quilting and the creative legacy of Black women. Let's check it out.
Today's presentation is called From Homemaker to Culture Shaper, Black Women's Creative Journey.
I'm Dr. Sharbrianne Plummer, and we are at the main branch of the East Baton Rouge Parish Library for my talk today, which is centered on Black women's creative work as homemakers and artists. Today, my presentation is sort of responding to Sarah Broom's The Yellow House as part of the One Book, One Community program for this year. And I will be sort of taking a look back, so looking at history, looking at Black women's work with fiber and textiles, everything from cotton in its raw form to sewing, quilt making, etc., and sort of painting a picture so that folks can see the progression between Black women in more domestic roles and how that contributed to artistry and how folks are using the same fiber and textiles in a more contemporary way. So I'll be drawing some tidbits from Sarah's book and how she talks about her grandmother and her mother and how they adorned their homes and themselves. And I'll share a little bit about my own research and the women that I worked with and what I learned about them during my dissertation process. And then I actually brought the work that I created as part of my dissertation that's still in progress, but I'll have it displayed at the front for folks to see. And I brought a few books as reference material so they could sort of skim through and see some of the things that inspired me as I was going through my research process.
Fiber was essentially the earliest kind of artistic medium that we had available for manipulation. So Black women often constructed clothing and used cloth to create things for wear and use by everyone on the plantation, right? And so in the midst of this, folks were able to also define their own personal style through mending and maintaining their wardrobes by making use of what was available to them. So in some ways, there you start to map out these sort of early knowings of creativity because it's like, okay, I'm going to make the best out of what I have. And I'm going to make it work and make it fashionable.
Why is it important to share this information at libraries?
I think it's important to share this information at libraries because libraries are spaces where you can come and access so much for free. For free. I actually grew up coming to this library. I spent my summers going down summer reading lists, and I learned so much. And for individuals who necessarily don't have access to a whole ton of books, like they can't purchase a ton of books, or maybe they don't want to go the traditional route and go through like 15 years of formal higher education. That doesn't mean that they should be limited in what they're able to access. So when you come into libraries, you're opening up the conversation to the general public, to individuals of all races, classes, economic backgrounds, etc. And you give everyone equal access to the same sort of information and experiences.
Wow, what an amazing program with such a rich expression. To find out what's coming up next, pick up a copy of our monthly newsletter, The Source, or visit us online at www.ebrpl.com.
Dr. Plummer brought some of her own work to show afterwards, and it was so interesting to see how she used all the different textiles to tell her own story. She even layered fabrics in such a way as to build her narrative with some pieces hidden behind others. If you weren't able to join us, you can view the video archive in the library's Facebook or YouTube channel. And of course, visit the library's homepage or visit readonebook.org to find out about other One Book, One Community programs this spring. Stay right there. After the break, Patricia Husband joins me for a chat right here on the Library Roadshow.
The East Baton Rouge Parish Library believes that free entertainment is good for us all. That's why we make ebooks and audiobooks available for free through the Libby app. Grant free access to unlimited streaming music and video through Freegal, Canopy, and IndieFlix. Get a library card. Get free entertainment at ebrpl.com/digital library.
You're watching the April edition of the Library Roadshow, everything you need to know about your local library system. Now, even though many of our patrons have been staying pretty close to home over the past few months, library staff have been keeping busy, out and about, and nowhere is that more obvious than at our newly renovated spaces with the Greenwell Springs Road Regional and Jones Creek Regional Libraries. Patricia Husband, Assistant Library Director of Branch Services, joins me now to share capital construction developments. Okay, Patricia, how about a quick update on Greenwell Springs?
Well, Greenwell Springs furniture has all been delivered. The project is finished, and our patrons are really enjoying the space, the new colors, the new designs. They're just really enjoying
it. It's bursting with colors,
it
man.
Is.
You want to feel happy, you just walk into the Greenwell Springs Road
exactly.
Regional Branch Library. And people are really, they're enjoying the different kinds of furniture because you found some really fabulous things.
Yes, the teens have some special chairs that are nice wingback chairs and some that swivel, and they like the movement.
And they have their laptop bar. They have
all kinds of fun places. The toddlers have some nice little wiggle seats, and the adult patrons have beautiful lounge chairs that and a quiet reading room to enjoy if they want to.
And then down the road, we'll be opening up study rooms and makerspace kind of areas, digital labs. It's all going to be there for them
yes.
as the COVID landscape changes and allows.
Exactly, and we're ready for that.
So that's been a long time coming. As we know, Greenwell Springs flooded during the historic flood of 2016. But they flooded 1 week after we had chosen the architect for a renovation. So it just kind of changed the scope of the project, and now here we are. It's so exciting. Jones Creek started a little bit later on the timeline. So what's their status?
So the last of the furniture should be arriving either this week or next week. They're going to be installing things like service desks and study tables in the adult area and computer tables for children and some study tables for children. We also have a letter wall that's going
to
be really exciting
That'll
for the children's area, beautiful colors. And but we're very close to wrapping up that. Final acceptance has been approved by the Metro Council, so we're really close to the end there.
And again, a color explosion.
Lots of color.
Yes.
Lots of color.
I really like the furniture choices there, and I like the way you move through the area, whether it's for adults, teens, or children. So. The children, they're going to have a large story time space. It's kind of like underneath a circus tent, isn't it?
Yes, it is. And some beautiful seating for parents and children to enjoy, adults and children to enjoy
experience.
As a family. We also have a number of study rooms, and we're bringing back our collection. So eventually, and I say eventually, meaning probably in the next month, we'll have the rest of our collection back there. So we'll be back up to speed with a full collection at Jones Creek.
That's great. Now, these two projects are wrapping up, so it's time to move on to the next one. And that means the South Branch Library.
Right.
So first of all, where is the South Branch Library? We've never had one.
The South Branch Library is going to be in the Roseanne development. It's going to be at the corner of Tupelo and Glasgow.
So the edge of Roseanne.
Right, the very edge of Roseanne, just off Perkins. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of catty corner behind where Sprouts is.
So that's the landmark for everyone,
right.
Isn't it? And what will it be like? What will be inside of this new branch?
Well, this new branch is going to have its traditional spaces, circulation, adult reference, children's, teens. It's also going to have a large meeting room that can be subdivided. We're going to have things like computers for all ages, mm-hmm. Some early learning computers in the children's area. We'll have study rooms and conference rooms, a story time room for children.
So the same things that we have
Lots
at
of the
all
same
of our
things.
Other locations
exactly.
or are putting into our other locations will be there. About how big are we thinking this library will be?
We're thinking between 16 and 18,000, and the final size has not yet been completely
sure,
determined.
Sure, that always kind of moves during design development. So a little bit along the size of the Fairwood Branch Library. Kind
a little
of what
bit,
we're thinking.
Maybe a little bit bigger.
Yeah. You can find out more and follow along with the progress by visiting the library's South Branch Info Guide. We've already posted the renderings, the elevations, and even a possible floor plan, and we'll keep adding to it along the way. After the break, author Julie Sternberg, plus book reviews from one of our younger library patrons. All that and more coming up next on the Library Roadshow.
The East Baton Rouge Parish Library believes that staying informed is good for us all. That's why we provide free access to the New York Times and other national newspapers online. Permit free access to niche magazines and articles through PressReader. Get a library card. Get informed at ebrpl.com/newspapers.
Welcome back to the April edition of the Library Roadshow. Julie Sternberg is the award-winning author of the best-selling Like Pickle Juice on a Cookie. Its sequels, Like Bug Juice on a Burger and Like Carrot Juice on a Cupcake, the Top Secret Diary of Celie Valentine series, and her picture books, Puppy, 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 and Bedtime at Bessie and Lil's. Her ninth book, the middle grade novel, Summer of Stolen Secrets, is now out. Julie joins me by phone to share all the details. Introduce yourself and tell us how you got started as an author.
My name is Julie Sternberg. I've written 9 books for kids now, but I never thought I would grow up to be an author. When I was a kid, I read and I read and I read. I spent a lot of time reading at the Goodwood branch of the East Baton Rouge Parish Library. I never thought I could write books. I thought books were magical and authors had some kind of magical powers, and I figured I could never do that. I started trying to write when I didn't have much time to read anymore. I had 2 young daughters and a job as a lawyer and no time to sink into books. So for the first time in my spare minutes, walking the dog or taking the train to work, my brain started filling with stories of my own instead of other people's stories. So I tried writing my stories down, and I learned that there's no magic to being a writer. It just takes sitting down and writing and rewriting until you're happy with the story. So that's how I got started as an author.
Julie, what is this new book about?
Summer of Stolen Secrets is about a 13-year-old girl named Katerina, or Kat, who has never met her strict Jewish grandmother, Safta. Safta cut off all ties with Kat's family because Kat's father married Kat's non-Jewish mother. Kat has never been to Baton Rouge, where Safta lives, until her Aunt Miriam invites her to visit for 3 weeks during the summer. At that point, Kat is desperate to escape her former best friends, who've turned into bullies. So she goes to Baton Rouge, and there, the tough and mysterious Safta puts Kat to work in the family department store. In that store, Kat uncovers secrets about Safta's escape from Germany and the Holocaust, which is a time that nobody in the family talks about. These secrets help Kat understand her grandmother and heal her family.
What inspired you to write Summer of Stolen Secrets?
I grew up in Baton Rouge in a Jewish family that owned department stores. Starting at the age of 5, I worked every Saturday morning in our store on Main Street in Baton Rouge. My grandmother, Leah, reigned supreme in that store and in my family. She was a tough character, and she and my grandfather had fled Nazi Germany in the mid-1930s. They used the money that they smuggled out of Germany, almost every penny of it, to buy the store. I've long wanted to write a book about a girl working in that family-owned department store in Baton Rouge with a tough grandmother who's difficult to understand and family roots in Nazi Germany. Summer of Stolen Secrets is finally that book.
Julie, what do you hope Baton Rouge readers will take away from this book?
I would love it if every kid in Baton Rouge got to read this book that's set in their hometown and that's based on a small slice of Baton Rouge history. I think it would be really nice for kids to kind of see themselves, at least where they live, reflected in the pages of a book. I also hope that readers come away with the start of an understanding of what happened to Jews in Germany in the 1930s and how that experience continues to affect families all these years later.
How can our viewers learn more about you?
You can find out more about me on my website, juliesternberg.com. I'm also on Twitter as @SternbergJulie, and I co-host a podcast called Book Dreams for everyone who loves books and misses English class. The podcast website is www.bookdreamspodcast.com.
Julie will be visiting the library in person later this summer. We'll be featuring Julie's series, plus taking a look back at We Were Merchants, which is, of course, the story of Godshaw's and Maison Blanche department stores. So keep your eyes peeled for hints on social media. Now time in the show to check in with one of our younger library patrons and find out what they're reading at the library.
Hi, my name is Margot. My favorite book is Possum on a Safe Day. It's about Paul's mom's mom running out of the accelerator to make Paul's son's birthday cake. And then one of Paul's mom's friends comes over to the baby alligator and so Paul's mom's mom says, go fetch me some silly celebrated to make the possum mom's birthday cake. My mom brings me to the library. When I come to the library, I like to look at the pictures from the books and go on the computer.
Thanks, Margot. Always great to hear what our younger readers are enjoying from the library. Stay right there. You're watching the April edition of the Library Roadshow.
The East Baton Rouge Parish Library System believes that knowing where you come from is good for us all. That's why we grant free access to genealogy resources available through Ancestry.com. Make the vast historic resources of Heritage Quest available to you online. Get a library card. Get your family tree at ebrpl.com/genealogy.
My name is Melissa Easton, and I'm head of the Special Collections Department of the East Baton Rouge Parish Library, located on the second floor of the main library at Goodwood, where Baton Rouge history comes alive. Jasper Ewing established his photography studio in downtown Baton Rouge in 1910. The Abbeville native started his photography career in 1898. He was a photographer during the Spanish-American War, and these images were subsequently featured in the World's Fair in St. Louis, Missouri in 1903. His career took him all over the world, photographing for the United States military. During the course of his career, there were many advances in photographic technology, including the introduction of mass-market panoramic photography, something he began to offer his clients soon after he opened his studio. Ewing took these images utilizing a circuit camera that had the capability to capture 360-degree images, but was used mostly to take 180-degree views. Patented by William J. Johnston in 1904, the circuit camera was manufactured by Rochester Panoramic Camera Company. The camera captured a panoramic image by pivoting horizontally along a vertical axis while a roll of film moved across the film plane. The Special Collections Department has several excellent examples of Ewing's panoramic photographs. This large image was taken from the top of the USS Nebraska during the record high water in May of 1912. The photograph spans the entire riverfront of Baton Rouge, panning south from above the Pentagon Barracks to the site where the water campus sits today. The next image was taken on the grounds of the original LSU campus in Baton Rouge, the site of the new state capitol complex. It shows the Knights of Columbus standing in front of the original Hill Memorial Library, and it is believed to have been taken sometime in the 1920s. Our final image is of an LSU Tulane game played in 1911. The football field was located on the west side of the Arsenal Park, now Veterans Memorial Park in downtown Baton Rouge. Known as the Battle for the Rag, LSU played Tulane 98 times, beginning in 1893 and ending in 2009. LSU won this game 6-0. To see more historical photographs, you can visit the Baton Rouge Room Digital Archive at www.ebrpl.com. You can see these three photographs in the Special Collections Department on the second floor of the main library at Goodwood, where Baton Rouge history comes alive.
You're watching the April edition of the Library Roadshow, a production of your East Baton Rouge Parish Library System. I love these old images. It's truly a glimpse into the past. And I love the fact that Special Collections is not only keeping them all safe for the future, but also sharing them in the digital archive. It's all available at the main library on Goodwood, and it's free with your East Baton Rouge Parish Library card.
Where there are books, writers like to gather. We're here at the Fairwood Branch Library to see where writers like to rendezvous.
I'm Heather, and we are at the Fairwood Branch Library. Today we're doing Writers Rendezvous, which is a writing group that meets at the library.
My name is Kathy Mayu, and I'm the founder of Writers Rendezvous. It's a project that was encouraged by Miss Heather at our Fairwood Branch Library, and I'm grateful to her for that, that we are acknowledged and that we get a lot of support. Writers Rendezvous is a writing group, and we get together to share ideas about writing, techniques, tips. We offer each other encouragement for our writings. We are introduced to new forms of writing a lot by having other members join us. It's also very nice when we are able to put on programs for an even wider audience of writers. And that way we learn from them and they learn from us.
Writers Rendezvous works on a lot of different things. I do believe last month they were working on haikus. Sometimes they bring in guest authors to do workshops and stuff. They do all kinds of stuff. This group is special because it is patron-led. So a patron named Miss Kathy Mayu is one in charge of it.
From me, who taught writing at LSU and BRCC, to others who are just beginning, we love it that young people often come to our groups to have writers in academia come and visit us and share, you know, what they're teaching in their classes now for aspiring young writers. And old ones like me, too.
If you would like to join a group like this at Fairwood Library, all you have to do is show up on the second Tuesday of the month at 6 o'clock. No registry required. Find more writers' groups like this in the events calendar at ebrpl.com, and find more writing and publishing resources in the digital library at ebrpl.com/digital library.
Thanks, Jessica. We love seeing local creatives come together at the library for some mutual encouragement and support of their writing process. We also offer a virtual fiction writers workshop and make sure that budding authors have access to such resources as BiblioBoard, plus all sorts of other learning opportunities for writing and publishing. We've rounded it all up in one convenient spot, the Writer's Info Guide. And now for today's contest. Visit the library's Facebook page at facebook.com/ebrpl. How about celebrating one of America's most famous writers? To complement the new documentary on Ernest Hemingway that's airing in April on public television, we're interested in seeing your best Papa Hemingway look-alike pose. And beard or no beard, we don't care. That's facebook.com/ebrpl. And while you're there, enjoy. We're not your grandfather's library anymore. What's coming up on the Library Roadshow in May? More fabulous authors, Sarah Broom and Margaret Wilkerson Sexton.
Tune in next month and I'll take you behind the scenes at another fun library program.
Next month, you'll learn about another service offered at your local branch library.
Thanks so much for joining us on the Library Roadshow. And remember, your East Baton Rouge Parish Library is open 7 days a week at each and every one of 14 branches, plus 24/7 on the web. Check us out at ebrpl.com.
And that's how we roll.